Okay, I'm going to do what I thought would generate the look that I was talking about earlier on that one vase. I'm going to blow with the ivory a cup, and then I'm going to do the overlay technique with that. But with the cup, I'm going to make a shape that is ridged in the optic mold, so that when I bring it out with the bubble on it, I'm going to cut those folds and then fold everything on top of each other. So some parts of it are going to have thicker two layers of the colored glass, and some are not going to have that much. So I think that'll generate more of an interesting look. So we'll see. And again, I'm going to just stick with a vase shape on that. And I've got some transparent now. It's an amber color, dark amber. I thought that would look good with that ivory. For the cup, I'm going to use a smaller pipe. I don't need the blowpipe hose or anything like that for blowing out this little cup. I've got some blanket on the sides of my pipe warmer, and sometimes that sticks to the pipe, so I was just cleaning that off a little bit there. So you look, suddenly you got four or five putties in the barrel. Got to keep up with putting them back in the warmer. Good and hot. Do a little collar and pick up some of that ivory. Such a nice day. Went into town, and you know, it's graduation weekend at MSU, and oh my gosh, there were so many people just out shopping and stuff, and lots of people in suits, and you could tell there's just a whole lot of celebration going on. Probably a great day for the restaurants in town. Interesting color. Looks like it's behaving real nice. Turning that up to 950 made a big difference as far as stuff cracking. And you know, I may still crack this cup when I pick it up, but that's no huge deal. So maybe I'll try a couple different techniques here, because I've got ivory. The overlay in itself will form that layered look, but the ivory has got that extra interesting part of it that allows it to react with these dark colors. So I might get into the black afterwards, but not sure. I may just try to keep it simple here. Something to think about some other time, I guess. Because I don't have the color out, which I could get out, but usually when I've been doing these cup overlays, I add a little transparent glass to it, and now it's sort of negate the ability to do any kind of color reaction with it. Kind of looks like cookie dough. Chocolate chip cookie dough. Especially when it's hot like that. All mushy. So I'm going to pull this color back down over the pipe like I've been doing. Down over the collar. Like so. Shape it up, put a bubble in it, and get another gather so I have enough to make a little cup. Don't think I'd get much of a cup out of this. The next bubble has got to be at least two gathers to pick it up. So this cup has got to be big enough to accept a two-gather bubble. There's a bubble in it. Cut a little bit of that glass off of there with these diamond shears. That much glass, just cut some off. try to blow it in one more time, get a little bit more puffed out than that. Better. Like a big old bell pepper now. Close up on the iPod camera. Thinking about is trimming it back to the point where there aren't, you know, they're to where the ridges start, so that when I do this overlay, everything is at that point. Probably heat this up and then trim it back, and then open it so that the ridges are. That whole opening's big enough to accept this other bubble. Thinking in my head how this is all going to work out. I'm just not sure. I think I got that a little hot. Yeah, just a little. Real hot. I don't even know what happened there. Dang. Started to melt. back, I guess. Yeah, so this is kind of a crispy color. It's gets a little plastic-like when it gets cold. Like old, old plastic. It's got to be more careful. Be interesting. That's what I'm going for right there. Just drop that off in the drop it in the color box. Pick it up in just a minute. That's nice and short this time. I can be sure it's not gonna crawl all the way up the piece. My thought was to pick that up and then cut each ridge and then let it fold over. I'm not sure that's going to work. I may just bring it over and try to roll it out, but I'll see if I can cut it. Just don't know. Don't know about that. Keep it relatively small, not get too big, so just go ahead and do two gathers. End up putting that blow hose on in a little bit, but it'd be a whole lot easier to maneuver and everything without it on, picking up that piece. So I may use this to steady myself when I go and pick it up. Size wise. I'm gonna burn this in, do one more layer, and then do the pickup. This is really going in easy. Really burns in nice. Very sticky color. Dark amber. Threw a little extra glass up here on the marver. It's got kind of a hazy sheen to it, just like the ivory did. To mix these two colors together too, the ivory and the, well, I found them, but not right on top of each other, so I have to try that. Definitely got a bubble. I think I'll point it a little bit so that I know it makes a touchdown with the very bottom of it. Go ahead now. Had to push it on there a little bit. Not sure that it got to the bottom, but I can always get the bottom off pretty good with those. Looks like a good pickup. I'm gonna try to tweeze those together. I think cutting it would just make it a mess. I'm not sure that it's ready yet. Yeah. Tweezing should be pretty easy though. Actually, if I do this on the marver, it's going to be fine because I did it in such a way that the bubble is not inside the ridges. So there's plenty of room there for the... I just need to go from the end back so that it forces the air up when I do it. Just get it real hot and then get that effect. I just messed that up, but I was afraid it was just going to cover the whole piece again. ripped into it there on the edges with the scissors. Didn't do a real good job of it. A great job of it, but because I really wanted to twist that before it fell down on the glass, and it ended up falling on it anyway. Let's see what kind of effect it gets anyway. I'm still gonna twist it, then get another gatherer and then blow this thing out. Interesting. This is something I always wanted to do. I mean, as soon as I started thinking about that guy's technique and doing cup overlays, I thought, wow, maybe that's a way to get that done. Felt like there was a little extra glass there. So I'm gonna just heat this in, smooth it out with the block, and then get another gather, and then blow another elongated vase shape. See what we got when it's all over. Where's my 8? It's interesting. It's definitely different. I may like this a lot. I don't know. Plenty of air, plenty going in there. I mean, this is gonna be striped. It's gonna be interesting. I think it's cool. It takes a lot of setup, but you know, I'm gonna run and get a little drink here. Try to add a little green in there if it looks like mountains. Sort of a blue background instead of the brown. Looks very Western at this point. Do a strip gather. We're going to gather and strip some off into the furnace. Probably should have put the blowpipe on. I forgot. thing to... Things cool down a little bit, but give me a chance to catch my breath. Yeah, this has got an interesting look to it. Looks more like his color technique than that other thing did. Maybe he made a cup out of that and then did the overlay. Could be. Transparent. With white on the outside, twisted, cup overlay, I don't know. If I were him, I wouldn't have showed everything. Got mine's all going in one direction, but his goes in two directions, I think. So maybe what you do is an overlay of it twisted one direction and then twist it the other direction when you pick it up. So, you know, just some refinements, but I kind of like this too. This also has that depth that suggests to me that it might be an overlay, like one is on top of the other. So I wouldn't be surprised if that's it. Something similar to what I did, except you'd put texture on that second bubble too. I'd say I'd stretch out the neck, but on this I don't think so, because there's too much, I'd lose too much color at the top. So I'm just going to blow out the top and work my way down. It's already pretty blown out. Not a real big piece. It out again pretty nice. Almost looks like a bowl. I'm going to try to blow it out a little more, swing it down a little bit first though. Goes. Nice. slides on the glass so nice. I think it's really helping the sides of these pieces I've blown. Get them real straight and smooth. Sure, the jacks aren't scratching the piece. It can definitely happen when it gets too cold. You end up with these lines. Look like crap. Can't get rid of them. About the only thing you could do is sandblast or frost the piece. I don't even know if that would work. Sandblasting would do it. A little scratch right there, down on the bottom. It's okay. Not great, but it's okay. Maybe I can fire polish that out here. I don't think so. Try to go a little hotter. And I'm about ready to turn this around and finish it off. Ready to get some nice pieces done, take them to some gallery. I mean, these are getting pretty nice. Not too much effort. Not like I'm killing myself to get this thing done. I think the scratch is gone. Yeah, that was temporary. That's good. Just want to make sure it's flat. New blow hose mouthpiece. New newspaper tool. Good stuff. Good stuff helping me blow glass, that's for sure. This thing's cool. This is still good and hot. I think it's because this amber color is just real friendly. It just doesn't chill off too easily. Because I've been out of the glory hole a little longer than usual. It's pretty straight. God, that looks so much like the technique that guy does. I'll tell you what. I think that video is missing something, unless I just didn't watch the whole thing. Yeah, like I want to do exactly like somebody else, but that is something cool to look at there. Took a little work, but see, we got some neat bubbles on the side. I didn't even do the mixing with the amber color and the black like I talked about doing. So there's a lot of variations possible here. In the back of my mind, I'm like, just get it off the pipe, dummy. Just get it off the pipe. Stop talking about the next piece. It's getting a little cold. Nailing these things as far as getting them straight, man. That's great. Straight on the punny. It's hot already. Oh yeah. Not quite hot enough though. This is pretty. good. Reheat it a couple times. Just make sure it's got a good heat in it. In a second, let it get back to 900. It was sitting right on top of some of this garbage. Don't want to touch it right now, or else it'll thermal shock it possibly. But once it gets up to 920, I can. That was fun. That was a great piece. I liked that. Go ahead and stop it, take a little break, and be right back.